The Bullseye cooling system is very good, but it does have one weakness, and that's in these mounting or support arms. This is printed in this configuration, and there's nothing but laminations in through here. If you bump this into something or drop this, it very quickly snaps off right here or in through here. This is just very weak. I've drawn these little doublers or support doublers, and they've got a small flange here and here. That flange catches the top of this support arm and indexes along this edge. So you want to sand this, rough up that plastic, and do the same thing on the inside of this. I'm using a gelled super glue. Put that on here and smear it around. I use this Dremel tool to get a real thin layer of that super glue. Then you take this piece and you put it on there, and those flanges index that straight away. Just double check it, make sure everything is down. And you put a clamp here and one here and let it sit overnight. The strength of this doubler is it being printed flat on the bed, and the laminations are this way. So when we glue that in place, it's adding strength in the opposite direction of the original support arm, and then that is quite strong. When these are glued in place and it has been clamped and the glue has had a chance to cure overnight, then that will fit right into the base. I don't intend to do this in orange. I just printed these so they would show up in the video. Now this one I've done in black. And they fit right up into the base. You will need a slightly longer screw for mounting this. But now, this is much stronger and less likely to break. The STL file for this is in my name on Thingiverse. You load this onto a Cura or your slicer, and then mirror it, and it'll give you a left and a right hand. So you have one for both sides of the pipe, and the file for this one will be there as well. The only difference is this does not have the flange at the top and along this side. I don't know why you would want this. This flange makes it extremely easy to install this. You don't have a whole lot of time when you're dealing with super glue. The STL file loaded into Cura, I duplicated it, mirrored it, that gave me a left and a right, and then I'm using an 8mm brim around this, printed 0.1mm layer and 100% infill.